That should be good right there. Is that good? I look so pale with the natural lighting. What can you do? What can you do? Go play with the white balance forever? No, not gonna happen. terrain. Pull up terrain. What does that have to do with starting the stream? I don't even know what that has to do with starting the stream. But it's time for Kerbal Boot Camp. I can't even say it right. I'm gonna have to start talking a lot more. Did the channel go live? Let's find out if the channel went live. Always have to do that. What is that? I don't even know what that is. Is it working? Can you see me? Let me know if you can't see me, because I don't know. I have no clue. And I need to go there. I need to go down here. I need to go over there. This is how unproduced all this is, right? It's live. Even if it's recorded, I didn't like produce it and cut in things and that sort of stuff. I just did it live. And I put it straight up. There we go. We'll just start at the beginning. We will start at the beginning and see how it works. Am I here? Can you see me? I don't actually know. Was today to send your craft day? No, Blipman. Today. Got that. Kerbal Bootcamp, learn to play KSP is what today is. And we are getting the stream spooled up just like we always do. How does that say? I don't know what that thing is for. What is that for? I don't know what that means either. I sent a link via message, Josh. Jade Fox! I saw it. I did in fact see it. I did see it. This is not working though, apparently. Alright, that doesn't look right. Streamer login. We got that. What is it logged into? Oh, there we go. Let's do this. Aha! How cool is that? Apparently that works. That's cool that actually works. That means we should have all sorts of new stuff in the channel that I got set up for boot camp. That's what I've been working on to try and get all this stuff set up. I did not expect it to actually get working. I wonder what the commands are. I don't actually know how to get to the commands. Points? Yes, is there. Excellent. Oh, heck yeah. Do I need to do anything there? No, I don't need to do anything there. That is that thingy. That looks cool. All right. I think we got it all done here. Stream interaction. I don't even know what that is. I wish I could turn that stuff off. I don't actually know how to turn it off. But that would be nice if I could turn some of this stuff off. Oh, there we go. Enabled. That's what we want. We don't care about that stuff. What is that? Q? I don't even know what a Q is. I'm not caring about that. We are ready to learn how to rock it. EPD 2005, we are there. Mods, if you're here, we may have some new commands to learn. Because I've got a new thing. Oh, there it is. Let's just turn all this stuff off. Nobody wants any of that stuff. I'm sorry. I don't even feel bad about it, honestly. I really don't even feel bad about it. Okay, we don't need that. So what do we have here? Yeah. Blipman, there's a window back there, and there's not anything I can do about it. That is just the, I tried to put something over the window, and that's just what it is. We've got a new thing here, and let me see here. Let me make sure this is turned off. Yeah, turned off, okay. Whoever wrote this thing really needs to, well, no. Ooh, I don't have that turned on yet either. Whoever wrote this thing really needs to do some user interface design work on it. Paint your window green, right? Yes, I'm going to paint my window green. That makes perfect sense. We've got that. Folks, if you're here for boot camp, that's what we're going to be doing. That is what we are going to be doing. We're getting some things set up right now. I'm Das Valdez. There's that. I hope nobody used that thing because I didn't have it up yet. I hope it wasn't supposed to scare me or anything like that. Did I make the background? No, that was actually released on the squad blog. That's what I was looking for. Let me do a quick roll call and see what we've got here. Wow, so many freaking people coming to the channel. In fact, let's see who I've seen say something. Unseeing Whale was in there. Gav, Nightbot. LADV. Lowell's Main. Starting right now. John Ayers, what's going on? Blipman, hey, how's it going? F5Bot, I don't know who that is. Maybe we'll find out. Scythily's here. Habisa Bid. I don't know how to pronounce that because I'm from Texas. But welcome, Habisa, to Kerbal Space Academy. We're going to be doing boot camp today. If you've never played this game before, you'll be able to soon. Slayer McGee is here. Crossover. Thank you again. I will be doing announcements on that in just a little bit here. Brimmer is here. Skunk Slayer is here. Jade the Fox. Quack84 likes the background. That's from Squad. That's not from me. Foxhound Ghost, did I get you? Oatium? I don't know how to pronounce that. AR12 Gaming made it as well. I am going to need to drink like crazy today. I am absolutely going to drink like crazy. Real Flyboy. Hey, everyone. Hey, Real Flyboy. How's it going? I am spooling up the stream. We're going to give people lots of time to get in here. Yargnet, did you get some sleep? I did. I hope you got some sleep as well. Thank you again for hanging out on my channel yesterday. I really appreciate it. But we are going to let this stream get spooled up. We have probably another 10 minutes here while we let people come in. Dino Man. What's going on? Suppressor. Ah, Suppressor also found me on... Was it on Twitter, I think? Yes, Twitter. I got something from Twitter from you. I do pay attention to what goes on. On occasion, I'm using my awesome thermos here to make me some awesome tea. I've already put honey in there, and I've got me some mint tea and honey. I'm going to be drinking that like crazy. That doesn't really sound like a very boot campy thing to do. I think at boot camp you're supposed to drink like shots of whiskey or something, but the instructors at least, after the fact. I don't know. Never been. What can you do though? Alright, there is a drink. That looks good. We're just broadcasting full stream while we got set up. And I've got something new. I don't think so, Gav. I don't think that many of the new commands, there really shouldn't be too many commands turned on right now. I've got most of it disabled. But I really wonder, let me try something here. Aha! I only have 2 credits. That's terrible. Nikium! Do I have Dr. Pepper? I've actually got a cooler full of Dr. Pepper today. That's the smallest one that would fit in my room over here, but I am prepared. Yes, Yarg, teach you how to get to the moon, 100% EVA. That's exactly what we're going to be doing. That is exactly what we're going to be doing. And I've got that set up. It's definitely going to need some balance. But it is a new thing. Why do you have half a credit more than me? That doesn't even make any sense. Time out. I don't know if I like that name. We'll see. Oh, what? That's dumb. What's the command to add 1,000,000 credits to me? There we go. Folks. We've got some new things here. I've got a new bot in the channel, F5Bot. You may see the name there, F5Bot. F5Bot is D-Bot, basically, right? Is D-Bot. Earthworm Slim was helping me out with some of that stuff. But it is going to be credits with a K. Is that okay? Does that mean something bad? Yeah, credits with a K is right. Brimmer, if a lot of people do the command at once, it actually queues them up and does it all at once. But we are starting right now. And what F5Bot is going to do, I wanted to get it running before I started the stream so that people could get credit for it. It is going to keep track of how long you watch the stream. It's going to give you Kerbal Space Academy credits. And we're going to be able to use those credits for some giveaways. Because we've actually got some giveaways that we are going to do during boot camp today. In fact, I'll probably change the channel title after a little bit. I want to see who the real fans are before we just have people coming in here for giveaways and that sort of stuff. But in order to participate in the giveaways, you'll have to earn credits. In order to earn credits, you have to watch. Another thing you can do to earn credits is participate. If you get my back on something, if you find something that I missed, only if I actually miss it, if you're just screaming things out all the time, not going to count. But if you totally get my back when I'm launching a rocket because I forgot the Kerbal or I didn't run a fuel line or whatever, I will award you with bonus credits, or mods will. award you with bonus credits. We will see how that works. We're just going to be seeing how we can get that stuff going. But watch the channel. You'll get credits. Participate in chat. You'll get credits. I turned off all the other nonsense. We're not going to be doing betting and bank heist and stuff like that at Kerbal Space Academy. That's not what it's about. That's not what it's about. Let me see if this is way too hot to drink, because I really need to do it. You can't watch you all the time. Yeah, Gav, if you find anything that that conflicts command-wise, let me know, and I'm sure we could do that. R. Brimmer, no, I have not. Why? Yes, I'm actually teabagging this. Apparently that's a thing. Trick is, it's actually tea. It's not a dead guy in Halo. So, we're just getting spooled up here. And then you load it in and we're like, yep, wheel missing. That was hilarious. It was like, the gunk. And I was like, oh no. And then I looked at it and there was only one wheel. Can't wait. Wait, can't we bet on if you're succeed or not? I think I do. I think I do have that up. Let me see. Where is that at? Sub, da-da-da-da-da. User channel commands. No, that's not it. Raffle alarm. Streamer messages. No, I don't have any of that. All right. I don't think any of that. Stream interaction. Music. Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I think the betting's there. I don't know how it works. It has start and reset. I guess we could do on that sort of stuff. That's not really a... I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. I don't know if we want to use that or not. We will definitely see. The quote command. It's got all sorts of stuff. Really, all I was really concerned about for this was the timer and the giveaway system. That is what I was trying to do. An American drinking tea. No, Mr. Junks. I know you'll probably stop watching my channel if I show you this. But no. It says Lipton on the box. I don't think that actually counts as tea in most time zones around the world. So please keep continue watching. That's all I can get over here. That's all I can get over here. That's all I can get. What can I do, though? Folks, we're continuing to let the stream spool up here, and I really, 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 really need to drink some stuff. I'm going to have to take care of my voice for this stream. Flavkoto, welcome, by the way. Cheers to you. Thank you for joining Kerbal Bootcamp. Do I have my Lexus? Yes, Lexus of Primbrope Kinds, official non-sponsor of Kerbal Bootcamp. I guarantee you they did not give me anything for doing this. Bebo Josh, you got KSP? You got KSP? Really? Bootcamp! That's awesome. Did you buy it on sale, Bebo Josh? Folks, we're going to be doing Kerbal Space Program. Since you're here, you probably already know that. What you may not know is that KSP is on sale right now at a freaking ridiculous steal of a price. If you want... You are more than welcome to not KR downloading similar. So many KR updates. What? Just get the latest one. There you go, Gav with the sale link. There are two things you could do. There's a demo you can download for free. Gav just put a link in the channel over there I saw. And it's actually on sale for a ridiculously amazing steal of a price right now. Normally it's like $30, $29.99 or something like that. It's on sale for what? Like $17, $18? Let me click on that link and see. $18.99 is an absolutely ridiculous amount for the game. Absolutely ridiculous amount for the game. Ay, 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 ay. So, I was thinking, online in time for the EU to watch. You're not even kidding, Pink Out Cup. Here's what I was thinking. If you don't have the game yet, and you want a completely awesome game, it's on sale. You can buy it. For $18, which is a ridiculously cheap price. It's a steal. It's like robbery, right? It's like robbery with this game. If I had to calculate the amount of money I spent per minute of playing this game, I don't even know what to tell you. But if you want, start up the game. If you don't have the game, since it's on sale, you could go buy it. You could go buy it, and we are going to take some time to get spooled up here, right? You got time. Go buy the game for $18. And here's the deal. Here's the deal. If you win one of the giveaways... I will actually reimburse you for the money you spent on the game, that $18. So if you buy the game right now and you win one of the giveaways, don't worry. I'll reimburse you for it. So if you want, I was trying to figure out a way to do that. And the rule is, if you buy the game right now because you want to play along with Bootcamp, we're going to be doing giveaways over the course of this. But if you buy the game and can prove to me, send me the confirmation email, something like that, prove to me that you just bought it, and you win one of those giveaways, I'll reimburse you for it. Because I want people to buy that game at $18. It's absolutely ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. Such a cheap price, and you can play along. If you have problems in your game, you can ask me. I'm right here, Dos Valdez, your bootcamp instructor, to teach you how to play KSP. That's what we're going to be doing. Right, checks, you're not even kidding. Screw the $60 games. Kerbal is totally worth it. I'm down under a cent an hour. Yargnet, I don't even doubt that. A cent an hour. I don't even know. I'm glad that it doesn't track how long I played the game. But I am probably way down there as well. Just in times, the amount of time I've streamed, we could just calculate it. Apparently Gav paid for about 9 cursive L's for it, however much that is. I don't know. Emperor77, what's going on? It really is. That's what I paid when I bought it back at 0.16. I'm doing good, Hectic. Thank you for stopping by. We're going to be doing boot camp today. We don't actually have the chat on the screen, so let me fix that right quick. I just noticed that. Let me fix the chat on the screen. There we go. And I need to go to Twitch. Do I have that window open? No, I had to shut down all my browser windows right before the freaking, right before I went live. You bought Kerbal way back when there was no moon or anything. Hey, that's me talking. I'm blue, not because I'm sad, but because there's natural lighting outside. What was that? Slayer McGee, 542. I like the $5. I also like the answer to life, universe, and everything. Slayer McGee, thank you for the donation. I do appreciate it. I do appreciate it. We are getting spooled up here. And that is the first donation. We've been live for all of what, like 10 minutes? And we already got one donation in Slayer McGee with the, not only the double super subscription, but the answer to the life, universe, and everything, which is awesome. So thank you for that, Slayer. I appreciate it. I was going to pop the chat out, so let's do that right quick. And you may be like, Das, why aren't you playing the game yet? And I'd be like, well, because I'm letting the stream spool up. I want people to get time to come into the stream. To come into the stream, to hang out and see what's going on. Thank you, Slayer. I will definitely enjoy it, mate. Thank you so much for that. Kicking off the donation train, he said. Let's actually get landed on the moon or something first. That would be maybe cool. Now I've got that. Oh, brother. And it's not going to actually let me do that. I'm going to have to switch streams. Let me see if that works right quick. Come on. Yeah, okay, so that's over there. And we have some Keith in coming in. We'll have to fix that. I normally don't stream during the day. I stream out of my bedroom. You can actually click on my donation link down at the bottom of the screen and see where I'm streaming from. That's what it looks like. Top Hat Dragon, thanks for the follow there. Appreciate the enrollment in Kerbal Boot Camp. Start playing after 100 people start watching. That's actually not bad. That's not a bad idea. Do you possibly need some art to use? I really do. I'd love to get some like 8-bit sort of stuff because that's kind of my thing, right? I'd love to get some like 8-bit Kerbals and 8-bit sort of stuff. You can fool around in KSP for a while. I could. We're just kind of getting things set up. Crew, can't stay long, but we'll be back later. Thanks for letting us know, crew. That's cool. This screen is never going to have the chat on it. We're just going to have to deal with that. Let me fix it from over here. Game KSP. All right, and I know I need to go like this. We'll fix that key thing as well. All right, there's that. Cybutech, I am going to be using your mod. I haven't updated all of my saves to the latest version yet, which is really a bit of a travesty, but I did it on purpose because I'm going to kick off boot camp by installing mods. You'll never guess which mod I'm going to install. Destroyer James, no, it is not a custom background. It was actually a squad release whenever they were hyping that up. Let me fix this key thing as well. Looks like I got the chat good to go now. Let me make sure it's not too high or low. Oh, that's not going to work. And let me scroll. Yeah, that looks good. That looks good. Now let me fix the key thing coming in. I really just wish... Nah, I don't wish I had a studio. I like streaming from my bedroom. We're already up to 94 people watching, and I'm just talking in front of a green screen. You guys are so freaking awesome. Cybertech, dude. Thanks for dropping by. It's always a pleasure to have you here on the channel. Hey, look, that's what my green screen looks like. See the window back there? There's a window, that's what the little lights are. Until the sun goes away, that's going to be happening. There we go. And slowly but surely, the key thing is going to kind of come around my head, and we're just going to have to deal with that. But that looks okay. This little thing right here, that's going to be a problem. That's the window going through. Yeah, there we go. I could actually block it with my hand. Maybe if I taped a piece of taped a piece of paper back there or something. Who cares? It's just light. Get over it. All right, game KSP. Let's go back to full screen. All right, that's me. I need to download. Guess it's going to be crew manifest. Green screen in the background is buggy. You're right. You're right, Heckard. We got it done. We got it done. All right. What's driving you nuts? I fixed it. I fixed it. I fixed it, Heckard. Sorry. Jeez, what could I do? It's the lighting. It's the lighting with a natural light in here. That's why I have to kind of, I have to redo it. Because the lighting, when the sun is up, it's like this light blue natural light coming in, mixing with the green screen is like, makes it kind of yellowish looking, I guess. Which is a little bit annoying, but, I'm definitely going to get that to it. My green screen is a bit off in the, yeah, Yargnet, it's daytime. And I'd stream out of my bedroom, and I've got a huge window here and a huge window here. That's really the only place I have to stream. So, now that you have the chat on screen, what are you going to do today? Boot camp, Flavcoto. We're going to do Kerbal boot camp. A lime screen. Yes, Cow Advanced Warfare. Thank you for coming back, by the way. So many people are here that were here with me when I signed off last night. I signed off like 10 hours ago or something like that. Yeah, as the boot camp progresses, the green screen will change. Gav is right. I'm going to be invaded by Keith Ann. I'm going to start to choke out like, and y'all have to tell me when to fix it. That is what we're going to do. We're continuing to spool up the boot camp stream here. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. Kerbal Boot Camp. Learn to play KSP. Me looking absolutely ridiculous over there. We're already over 100 viewers. And it's just me talking in front of a green screen. Remember some new features. Some new features. The longer you watch, the more points you will get. You can actually check it by typing credits. Credits. I'm already up to 5. I've apparently watched myself. There was another donation. $10 from West Coast Surf Bum. Get some Dr. Pepper and Bluebell ice cream. West Coast. I don't recognize your name. Have you ever said anything in my channel? $10, that will definitely get me some Bluebell ice cream. That'll give me a gallon of Bluebell ice cream. I love the Dutch chocolate ice cream. And Dr. Peppers. I've got a cooler full of Dr. Peppers down here so that I don't have to do anything. Get up, that sort of stuff. It's with a K, it's with a K. There you go. Look at that chat spam. Love it. Thank you, West Coast Surf Bum. I will absolutely get some Dr. Pepper and Bluebell ice cream. That's amazing. Now I want to go get Bluebell ice cream, though. I'd never be able to talk then. Look at all these people. It has been a while. There you are, West Coast. Thank you for that donation. It has been a long while since you've said anything in my channel. F5 bought a bot picture just like Nightbot. Sure, at some point. That wasn't the top of my game today. Maybe if somebody had a hectic. Yeah, we got that under control. We got that under control. The thing was to stream hard and long this week, which we have been doing. We've been doing some very serious streaming this week, and after boot camp, that's what I'm going to do. We've got it all set up. I should eat on stream. Is Casper here? I can't eat on stream till Casper's here. Let me make sure I'm not going to lose my headphones here. Yeah, my batteries are charging. Good. We continue to let the boot camp stream get spooled up in just a little bit after everybody who wants to watch is here. We are going to learn to play Kerbal Space Program, starting with installing mods. Starting with installing mods. Frogfan, good question. We want it longer and harder. I'm giving it all she's got, Captain. He's back already. Hardcore DOS. Thank you, PureFX. 108 right now. Nice. So, I almost wonder if I should... Nah, that's fine. You will be able to use the credits later on in the stream for giveaways. Four giveaways. There we go. Look at that. Thanks to Smego for hosting the stream. Well, that's cool. I didn't know the bot did that, but that's cool. Professor M is back as well. Coming on in the stream, you'll be able to use the credits. Where is the teabag thingy? There it is. You'll be able to use the credits to participate in giveaways. In giveaways. Because we are going to be giving away some copies of Kerbal Space Program from Squad. Courtesy of Squad, honestly. Is it crew manifest? Did I guess correctly? Crossover, let's do that too. That's a good idea, honestly. That is a good idea. We'll install crew manifest as well so we can use some in-channel names. That is not a bad idea at all. That is not a bad idea at all. But with the credits, the longer you watch, the more credits you get. Over the course of the stream, we'll be doing giveaways. You can play it however you want it. You can either wait till the end of the stream and buy a bunch of tickets at the end of the stream so you have a higher chance to win that last giveaway, or you can participate in every giveaway and have a lower chance to win more giveaways. You can do it however you want, but it will be up to you, and you will have to use some of your KSA credits to participate in the giveaways. A couple ways you can get credits just sitting here watching me. Are we allowed to give it to our friends? I didn't really think of that. Let's use cadets as landing gear. I didn't really think of that. I'm not sure if you can transfer them around. I don't know. I will have to think about that. I'm not truly really worried about that. Generic profile name. I haven't even decided yet. Right now it says that you get a point every 5 minutes. There are how many sets of five? Why can't I do that math in my head? Time out. There are 12 fives in 60, so you'll get 12 points an hour? So maybe it's just going to be like 10 points or something like that. Maybe it's just going to be like 10 points or something like that to participate in the giveaway. Give Dos Valdez one. Did that work, Hectic? It doesn't work. All right, good. We'll just leave it that way. Earn your own credits. That'll keep people from having multiple accounts that aggregate all the points together and stuff like that. My fraud prevention mind kicked off the second you asked me that, if you could transfer them around. The first thing I thought was, well, then you could have multiple accounts and you could aggregate them all into one account. And that doesn't seem fair, does it? We can transfer codes. I don't know what that means. If they paid for the game and a friend won it, I think it would be great to have more people playing. If they paid for the game and a friend wants it, I think it would be great. I absolutely agree. So when we do the giveaways, and you win a copy of Kerbal Space Program, if you buy the game right now, if you spend $18 on the game because it's on sale for an insane, insane sale price, right like that, is it going to work? Come on. There we go. If you buy the game right now and you win one of the giveaways, I will reimburse you that $18. So don't sit there and be like, oh man, I don't want to buy the game. I don't have it, but I don't want to buy it because I want to maybe win a giveaway or something. Don't do that, because if you win the giveaway, you'll still get the game for free. I will reimburse you. We'll figure that out, but I will definitely reimburse you if you win. And you can prove to me that you just bought it today, right? Send me the email or something like that. We'll figure that out, though. Credits. Yes. All right. Transfer the KSP codes to friends if you want. Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, you could totally transfer the codes. We do have Steam codes to give away. That's what we're going to be doing. All right. Didn't answer somebody's question. Whose question didn't I answer? Emperor, what did you ask? Credits. Can I get some email to send you art? Oh, Emperor, let's see here. Did you ever get a helicopter to fly? I did not do that. What are you going to give away? Copies of KSP? What else would we give away at Bootcamp, Sycon? Copies of KSP is what we're going to be doing. Excuse me, by the way. I just had a question that I was answering, and then I missed it. Where is it at? Dr. Pepperkin. Oh, Cal Advanced Warfare. What happened to my Dr. Pepper KSP can? It's still in all the saves. Manifest. 244. How are we doing on viewers? Getting spooled up, like I said. Up to 120. That's not too shabby at all. Flav Koto, I'm watching you while I'm doing my human body project? Interesting. Tanaka Legion, or Tanaka Legion, I think it is, and generic profile name, and Top Hat Dragon. Thank you for enrolling in Kerbal Space Academy. I'm Dos Valdez. We're going to be doing Kerbal Bootcamp today. Bebo Josh, we are started. I don't know what you're talking about. The stream has started. I don't know what to tell you. So many people are so impatient, but I really want to give people a chance to come in here, get the stream spooled up, and see from the beginning so I don't have to repeat myself, right? Would you rather that I start right now and have to repeat myself 5 times because people come in and then ask the same question that I've already answered? Or would you rather sit here and hang out with us so you can learn the rules of the chat, how to participate in giveaways, all that sort of stuff, and then we stream up and I don't repeat myself? You just logged in time to hear about the copies being given out. Bipolar Life 269. You are correct. We're going to be doing that. How long have I played KSP? August of last year is when I bought the game. August of last year. We're already up to 126, as much as we ended with today. You're right, Elad. Elad. a lot of... I really wish I knew how to pronounce that. That's a donation. Whoa. Pink Cal, you donated last night. You donated like less than 12 hours ago. You donated less than 12 hours ago. Again, I appreciate your service, first off. I appreciate your donation, and you don't have to donate to within 24 hours, within a week, within a month even. But I appreciate that, and also your message. Dude, just gave 10 bucks to Cybatech and the rest of my gaming allowance for the month to you. Thanks again, man. Keep up the good work. My Kerbals are happy. I am no longer slamming them into celestial bodies. That's hilarious. Also, thank you for supporting Cybatech as well. Cybatech is awesome. He's got so many freaking... Shush, Hectic, shush. Cybatech is so awesome. He really takes care of the KSP community. He listens to our feedback. He includes things in Kerbal Engineer, which we're going to be installing in just a minute. He is going to... I don't even know what to say. Cybatech's awesome. So, Pink Owl Cup, thank you for that donation to the Academy, which helps us keep the Academy going, and to Cybatech for helping... I mean, for just thanking Cybatech that he does all this work. And the really cool thing is, guys, I love it when people donate to Cybatech, but Cybatech was doing this before he was getting donations. And it's really good. I mean, I think it's really awesome that now we're kind of giving back to him, because he didn't expect... donations. He didn't expect people to pay for his hosting fees and that sort of stuff. But when you donate to Cybatech, you help out Kerbal Engineer. When you help out Kerbal Engineer, you help out Kerbal Space Academy. When you help out Kerbal Space Academy, I'd like to think you help out Kerbal Space Program and Squad and all that sort of stuff, because we want to get more people playing this game. I know, LADV, it's a thing. It's a thing, because I've actually got a little cutout. See how I'm like cut out right there, and I've got two copies of the thing? There is a little bit of a green outline around the edges. I know. It's okay. The hype for boot camp is raising. You're right. The boot camp hype train. It's just that DOS is the coolest one in the club. I don't even know what to say about that. Hecked it, dude. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy, man. Serterpiv is excited to be here for a herbal boot camp. I don't know what that means. A herbal boot camp? An herbal boot camp? The talk box. Get a drink. I've got lots of drinks. I definitely have lots of drinks. Thank you. Guys, remember to remind me to drink. Belisle Doss, I picked up the Kerbal back in 1.8. Besides Scott Manley, you were one of my favorite KSP players. Thank you, Belisle. I appreciate that. In fact, we're about to start... I'll start being a KSP player. Because I'm not right now. We're just hyping up boot camp right now. Pale Rider again, thanks for the donation yesterday. Boot camp hype, says Nikias. Nikium, Mike McGov, I'm doing good. Right here, I've got some mint herbal tea and honey. I also have more hot water over there, and I've got an entire cooler full of Dr. Pepper at my feet. Boot spawn camping. Yes, I'm going to give you my address. 123 Wallaby Lane. Wallaby Way, wasn't it? Muhammad Mama. Yeah, they are. The lighting in here is really bad, too. The lighting in here is really bad too, but you want to know what's wacky? You want to know what's wacky, Muhammad Mama? Without these, I look like an absolute tool. I don't look right at all without my headset. I mean, look at my hair. I got my boot camp cut going and everything. But, welcome to the stream, Muhammad Mama. You're right, I've got natural lighting in here. They got a little bit of a green tint. If you want to look at something, just look at the graphs over here, or check out my vampire fangs. But he always says something about Steam says it's $30. Silverstein, here's a link for you. Let's get this done. I think that now is a good time to start this boot camp, y'all. We have 137 people watching. 137 people watching. That's not too shabby. We are going to go ahead and get started with the boot camp. 32 Wallaby Way, Sydney. That's right. Thank you. 32 Wallaby Way. Shark bait, ooh ha ha. You're surrounded with is a urine bag. Thank you, that's exactly what I need. That's my haircut for Jay Rutsy, nice. 144, 147, is it really going up that fast? Are you kidding me? Shark Jay Bootcamp. Here for the support, Das. What did I miss? Nothing yet, that's why we let the stream get spooled up, Gaffer. That is why we let the stream get spooled up, so that people have a chance to get into the stream. Don't ever take... I know, right, LADV? I don't look right at all. Ionic, wait! What's going on? Fearsome Fish, hello. Machmo made it as well. Jeez. I don't even know what to tell you. Folks, before I get started, let's talk just for a second. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. I'm Das Valdez. Academy person. Kind of what I do, right? But at Kerbal Space Academy, the entire thing is learning to play Kerbal Space Program. Boot camp especially is targeted at people who have almost never played the game before. Maybe you have the game, maybe you've crashed a few rockets, maybe you beat your way into orbit once or twice, maybe you got a few solar orbits probably, right? That seems to be what everybody always does first. But maybe you don't even have the game yet. If you don't have the game yet, it's on sale right now. You can totally buy it. And I am going to show you how to get into space. Not only am I going to show you how to get into space, into orbit, I'm also going to show you how to get out to the moon. If we have time at the end of the stream, I'll show you how to build a space station and dock it. I think we'll go with the space station today. I think we'll go with the space station. If we have even more time, maybe we'll do a space plane. But the stream is targeted at people who don't know as much about KSP. Maybe your level of KSP expertise is low, or you think that there's some things you could learn. There's lots of different things, right? But what I do in this stream, I don't have a script. We're talking boot camp. I'm going to start from the very beginning as if you've never played the game before and explain everything to you. Why am I beeping? There we go. I'm going to explain everything to you and what I want you to do. If you have the game, feel free to play along if your computer can handle it. You can open it up. You can build the same ships. If you have problems in your game, I want you to come into my chat right here and say, Das, I have a question. And I'll be like, oh, really? What's your question? Look at Gav preempting me there. I want you to come into the stream and I want you to say, hey, Das, how do you do this? Or question, how do you work like this? That was another donation. Who was that? DSM20T. No message. DSM, thank you so much. You are a frequent supporter, and I really do appreciate the donation. Thank you, DSM. Thank you for the donation. I was just talking, in honor of DSM, I was just talking PureFX as well. What? Cheers, mate, says PureFX. Thank you for that. Cheers, mate, PureFX, I appreciate that. DSM and PureFX, so in both their honor for those two awesome donations. That's the same that I would get if they subscribed for 4 months, right? PureFX and DSM, in your honor, I will continue on. A freaking and freaking and freaking supporter. You're right. If you have questions, come into my stream, say DOS. It'll highlight in red. You see it highlighted in red, right? What I do every now and then, I scroll back through my chat. I stop playing the game. I scroll back through my chat, and I answer the questions. It doesn't matter if you have a question about an engine. Why does this engine work? How does the fuel work? Why doesn't my rocket get into space? My rocket completely explodes, da-da-da-da-da. You know what I mean? You can come to my chat, you can ask me those questions, and I will answer them right here live on the stream. That is boot camp. I want you to open your game. I want you to play along. If you don't have it, buy it. Even if you want to, you could download the demo. There's a free demo. Cue the demo link, right? Even if you don't do that, you can only get the demo. You can play along. If you have questions, bring it right into here, into my channel. Ask me the questions. Use the word DOS, it'll highlight in red, and I will catch it. I will answer it. Use the word question, it'll highlight in red. I will answer it. That is how Kerbal Space Academy works. Some people sometimes get a little bit, sometimes, the chat's not on the screen right now. Thank you, Godfather Bobo. In fact, when I was saying that it was highlighting in red, I meant like this. There we go. You can see over here, up that way. I'm a terrible weatherman. It highlights in red. Whenever you say the word DOS, you say the word question, that's what's going to happen up there. That's what's going to happen. So, actually, I just leave it on the screen for now. I don't need to be huge. Last thing I want to say. Actually, two last things I want to say. We've already talked about the giveaways. You earn points just for being here. I appreciate that. We'll be using those points, those credits, to participate in giveaways later. If you participate in chat, if you answer questions for people, or if you get my back, you'll get additional credits, right? That's a good way to get some additional credits by participating. Are you kidding? Cybertech, that is awesome. DSM20T just helped you out with a 10 curly L recurring donation as well. Cybertech, dude. Good times, Cybertech, good times. DSM, thank you for supporting Cybertech as well. Guys, Cybertech, if you didn't know, the guy with the green sword on his name is the maker of Kerbal Engineer that we use. In fact, we're going to install it in just a second. But, like I was saying, this is Kerbal Space Academy. I answer questions. I talk, right? I interact with the chat. Some people are like, Das, look at this ugly black screen you've got. You've just got this big ugly black screen. Your game is so boring. I'm sorry you think that, but I really want to answer questions for people. and I really want to help them play the game, and I really want them to be able to accomplish freaking amazing things like you see on KSP TV, right? I want to help people do that because it's not that hard. You just have to learn a couple basic things. You got to practice a couple basic things, and you can freaking go on Space Quest like Shimmy, who is broadcasting, right? You can do that stuff. You just got to learn a couple basic concepts and then apply it. Oblivion ISC, thanks for the follow. Last thing. Curly L. It's a curly L, yeah. Here's what we're going to do. Last thing. Kerbal Space Academy is a family-friendly channel. So just watch the language. It's not that big of a deal, but I have a lot of people that come into my channel and are like, Das, wow, me and my kids watch, and we love to play KSP, and we love to launch rockets, and we love to watch you. So my Kerbal Space Academy streams, especially boot camp, I do as a family-friendly stream. So just keep it classy, you know? Watch the topics you talk about. Wonder if there's like a 12-year-old kid or an 8-year-old kid who's really into rockets, really into space, watching the channel. Maybe think whether or not that 8-year-old or 12-year-old kid should be able to see the type of stuff you're saying. Just watch the language and keep it classy. You know what I mean? In retired army, it's okay. You know what? We're pretty good. We're pretty good. Don't worry about it. But just keep it classy, y'all, because we really want to spread this to everybody. If I can get kids interested in science, in space, and that sort of stuff by streaming Kerbal Space Program, I want to do it, and I want them to be able to watch the stream without their parents being like, oh my gosh, look at this guy teabagging stuff or whatever. That's really not what I want. I want it to be family-friendly. So I do appreciate y'all. Curly L, JTN, GameSprider, thank you for the follows. Looks like I missed a couple people. Folks, it's time to get this started. It's time to get this started. Let me drink. Curly L, Kappa. Okay. Time to get it started. Again, turn on your mic so we can save your voice more. Turn your mic. That's about right where it is right now. That's about right. Kerbal Space Program is an awesome game. In and of itself, without even any mods, right? There's a lot of stuff you can do. You can blow up a lot of stuff. You can have a lot of fun even without mods. But I've got a list of must-have mods. If you scroll my channel down, I've got a list of must-have mods right there at the top of the channel description. I really think that the game is a lot easier to learn if you have these mods. So, I'm going to start off bootcamp right here showing you how to install mods. And we are going to install a very important mod at the beginning here. We are going to actually install Cybatech's Kerbal Engineer in my Kerbal Space Program game right here. If you don't know how to install mods, watch right now, because I'm going to walk you through. I'm actually going to stream my desktop. In fact, can we go Infinite DOS? Let's see what it looks like. Oh, that's not Infinite DOS. Oh, no, it doesn't do Infinite DOS anymore. Ah, oh, that's so lame. That's better. I'm going to put this over here just because I like this Infinite DOS thing. Guys, install Kerbal Engineer. Good times, though. Good times. What is that line across the stream? That's interesting. Is that light coming through? Oh, the sun is right there. Look at the sun on my face. I'm going to have to get out of the way of that. We're just going to roll with it. Folks, this is Infinite DOS mode. It usually means that I'm going to install something. If you need to install a mod, and I recommend that at the very least you install Cybatech's Kerbal Engineer, right? You can get it installed. It's really simple. Here's what you do. Open up your KSP install folder. If you bought it directly from Squad, it's going to be wherever you installed it. You can see mine is just local disk games KSP 125. This is the 0.25 update. If you have Steam, it is a different path. If somebody could put the Steam path over there, the default Steam path, into chat, it's easier if it's just right there in chat so people can copy-paste it, sort of deal. But mine, I downloaded directly from Squad before they had it on Steam. So mine is like this. Local disk games, KSP 125. Your folder name may be different. I named it that just so I can keep it straight. And in this, you should see ksp.exe. You see it right there, right? ksp.exe. You can see it. I have a recipe for chicken cacciatore up on my screen right now. Smart jokes. There's the SteelSeries mouse I was looking at. I mean, whatever. I checked it. There's the KSA cheat sheet doc that I was working on. Anyways, I totally even have this. That's on my desktop, apparently. Anyways, so you get to the folder where KSP is installed. You see KSP.exe right there. Thank you, CH Rogers. Thank you for that. I appreciate it. Hectic as well. Guys, thanks. Oh, we're going to have to figure out how to do that. Somebody give Hectic, Pale Rider, and CH Rogers 5 credits each. Let's see how that works. I've never really done that before, but somebody give Hectic, Pale, and CH Rogers 5 credits each. I don't know how to do it. We'll figure it out, though. But anyways, you've got ksp.exe right here. This is the correct folder. You should see one called Game Data. If you open up Game Data, you can see this is where my mods are actually installed. You can see all the mod folders here. Yours may be empty if you haven't installed any mods yet. I've actually got some mods already installed. So now I have KSP125 Game Data. Let's go back down here so that I see the Game Data folder right next to ksp.exe, right? And here's what we're going to do next. Here's what we're going to do next. You just search for KSP to get to the folder. That makes sense. That makes sense. Hectic. Hectic, how long are you going to be here? If you could, tell me how long you're going to be here, because I could use some help in terms of people who know how to use the bot. So let me know how long you're going to be here, Hectic. Let's see here. The next thing I want to do, I'm going to go ahead and open up a new window. We will go to... Is there anything on that one? No, that's fine. Open up a new window. Let's go to forums, or actually just forum.kerbalspaceprogram.com. I'll go like this. That will bring you to the KSP forums. This is where you get mods. Hectic can stick around for a while. Awesome, Hectic. Awesome. Let me do this right quick. Hectic. Da 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 da. XXX. XXX, yep, 9001. Did I do that right? Hectic, XXX, 9001. There you go, Hectic. If you could help us out with some of the deep bot commands and hang out for just a little bit, I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you. Guys, I follow Hectic, if you didn't know. I follow Hectic. I actually can't see it right there. Over here we could see it. That was the wrong window. But I do follow Hectic right there. Hectic is another streamer. Hectic, if you could help us out some, go ahead and add 5 points to those 3 guys that put the links in. Yourself included, so start off by giving yourself 5 points. Anyways, thank you, Hectic, for the help. I really do appreciate it. And then some of the other mods can learn some of the commands as well, right? What we're going to do, you can come over here to the forums, right? You can come over here to the forums. So it is DeepBot. Then, yeah, I can do some stuff. Nice. Thank you, Hectic. I appreciate you. What you do, you go to forum.kerbalspaceprogram.com. We're getting a mod here, right? Come on down here to add-on releases. Click on add-on releases down here in the forum. There's so many awesome mods here. You want this link right here, Community Mods and Plugins Library. It is an absolutely great link. You click on it, and instead of scrolling through, instead of searching for things, you can actually see all the mods and their compatibility, what version it's compatible with, right here. You can get parts. You can get armory. There's BD armory right there if you want to blow stuff up, add battle damage and stuff. Like, there's a bomb mod, apparently. HyperEdit, clearly under cheats, right? Clearly under cheats. You've got NavHUD up here. You've got a... Deb Refund, that one is not updated quite yet. You've got Better Than Starting Manned. Bevo was streaming that last night, I know. You can scroll through this one post on the forums, and you can, like, shop for mods, right? The mod that I am shopping for is right here, Cybertech, Kerbal Engineer Redux. How do you pronounce that? Redux? Redux? All I know is it's in the Hot Shots movie title. Anyways, I don't know what to say. All right. Excuse me. So I've come over here, I found Cybertech's link to Kerbal Engineer, right here. All I do is click on it. That's going to open it up. Guys, this is very important in Cybertech. I have some feedback for you right here live on the channel. I get a lot of people who I send over to this post, and I'm like, hey, download Kerbal Engineer. And they're like, all right. And they come over here, and they click right here, the biggest in-your-face above the fold, right, above without scrolling, above the fold link that says download from CurseForge. What people don't understand is this is the official... older version, 0.6, not the cool version I use in my stream. So if there was some way you could split that up or make it more obvious that the version you want is this public test release right here, I think this thing is really stable enough to maybe not even call a test release anymore, right? But I use this one right here. I don't use 0.6 up at the top. I use this one, 1.0.11.1. And this is the download link you want to use, not this one up here. I'd get a lot of people whenever I send it over there, they download this and they're like, I have to put the parts on. It doesn't look the same as yours. It doesn't have the suicide burn. And I think it's because they're clicking on this first above the fold download link. You want this one, public test release, version 1.0. download from CurseForge right there. That's the one you want to download. Hold on, let me try this out on somebody else's channel. Yeah, I don't actually know. We'll have to see. Is there something I have to do? But this is the one you want. So what you're going to do... Did that work? I don't know. We'll have to see that. Remove the 0.61 and completely and just list... Or change the order of them or something like that. That would be my recommendation. But anyways, we're here on the Engineer Thread forum post. We want to download this public test release. Download from CurseForge right here. You can click on that, and it will bring you to this page. From this page, this is the CurseForge page for Kerbal Engineer. Download, it's a little bit hidden, a little bit more feedback. This is for CurseForge, but this download link up here is in a space that is normally reserved for advertisements and banners. Not a great place to put that, but look for it. It's right up there. That's why I'm streaming it, so you can see it, right? Right up there. So go ahead and click on download. That will download Kerbal Engineer, right, like that. And after you've downloaded, all you really have to do is open the zip file. It comes down in a zip file, like that, and it has a couple things. You can see right there it says Kerbal Engineer. So I'm going to go back to my other folder just to put these next to each other like this. I've got my KSP install folder with KSP.exe and the game data thing right like that, right? What I want to do is grab this Kerbal Engineer link right there. Oops. Grab the Kerbal Engineer folder right there, and let me spread this out a little bit. That's what I was trying to do. Drag the Kerbal Engineer folder into the game data folder. That's all you have to do to install the mod. It's really simple. You drag Kerbal Engineer into game data. If you've never installed it before, you won't get these pop-ups. I already have it installed, so I'm just going to go ahead and overwrite. But the important thing is I did not do this. I did not drag Kerbal Engineer into this folder, right? Copy to KSP 125. That's not where we want it. We wanted to say copy to game data, right? Like that. Another thing that I did not do. Let me go ahead. Yeah, if it asks you this, just copy and replace. Do this for the next conflicts. Copy and replace. Do this for all current items. Yes. Kerbal Engineer is installed. What I wanted to say, the other thing that I did not do, I did not open up the game data folder and drag it like this. Right? Do you see what it says there? Copy to precise node. Copy to environmental visitor enhancements, whatever. That is not... Why did that go away? You do not want it to copy into a folder. You need it to look just like this. KSP 125 game data, Kerbal Engineer, right like that. That's how you install that mod. In fact, that's how you install any mod. That's how you install any mod. So let's do it again, right? Let's totally do it again. Let's come back over here. Let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of that. Not that we don't love Cybertech. And there was another one over here that was what allows you to name Kerbals. There's one that allows you to name Kerbals, and it is called Manifest of some sort. So I'm just going to search. There we go. Kerbal Crew Manifest. That seems good. Let's download Kerbal Crew Manifest and get this one installed. Kerbal Crew Manifest, version 0.5. Was it compatible? Yeah, it's compatible with 0.25. You can see right there, 0.25. Kerbal Crew Manifest. Let's scroll down. There's the download. Instructions in the flight scene, click on the manifest. Okay, that's not install instructions. Guys, when you download a mod, please try to read the installation instructions if there are any. Just read them. Don't do it wrong. Don't completely ignore it and then come over to the thread and bother the person who made the mod with questions that they've already answered. You just didn't read them because you were too lazy or too busy or whatever. Look for instructions. Make sure you read them. I don't see any installation instructions. Maybe there's some of the download. So I'm going to click here. There is the download. Excellent. Let's just go ahead and open it up. Like that. Let's bring this folder back up. Like that. Now, this one's a little different. Do you see how this one, actually, the Crew Manifest 590.zip, this actually has a game data folder? What do you think you're going to do, right? If you want, you could drag the game data folder over to here and make it say copy to KSP 125. What I suggest is you open up this. There is Crew Manifest. See how it's game data Crew Manifest? You want that exact same path in your game install. So drag Crew Manifest over to game data. Right like that. See how it says copy to game data? And whenever I let go of that, I want it to say, when I go into game data, crew manifest right there. So I've got my install folder, game data, crew manifest, like that. So now I've installed two mods. I've installed the updated Kerbal Engineer, which is absolutely amazing, and I've installed crew manifest because I'm going to be killing some of you today in boot camp. Sorry. What can you do? I think it's a lot of fun, though. I've seen a bunch of different streamers, Shimmy and stuff like that. Using viewers' names to go on missions. So when I do this, I'm going to be, step up, cadet! get in the rocket. It's time to launch you to the moon sort of deal. That's what we're going to do. All right. You have to be mod level 2. Oh, okay. Let me get caught up with chat as well. Let me close these things down. Let me get the game loading up. Let me get the game loading up. I missed some stuff. How do I get the mod stuff from the beginning? Sorry. Help. Bebo Josh, go to the forums. Go to this link right here. That's where you can download the mods from. And then you just drag them into the folder, just like I showed you. Guys, I have not been caught up with the chat yet, but I'm going to do this. I'm going to get this game loading. I'm going to get the game loading. Whoa! That always makes me happy to see Infinite DOS. All right, let me bring this back to the other window. Oh, look at this. Maybe we shouldn't stream that window. I think it's okay, though. The chat was blocking the destination folder. The chat was blocking the destination folder? Really? Was it? Whoa, okay. Well, let's fix that right quick. I was just told the chat was blocking the destination folder. So let me go here. Let me go games. Let me go win25. There we go. The destination folder is this game data right here. I dragged Kerbal Engineer into this game data folder. And I dragged... where is it at? Crew Manifest, wherever it is. Crew Manifest into this. So all you do is you unzip the file. You drag this into game data right like that. Thank you. Thank you that, by the way. Thank you for that. Right there, game data, crew manifest, game data, Kerbal Engineer. That's the destination folder. Thank you for that. All right, so let me get the game started up. I needed to come there anyways. And let's just launch Kerbal EXE. Run it, and it will get set up. More DOS, run away, all cadets. Yes, run away, run away. I'm not going to worry about that. Let me get caught up with chat. What did I need to do? You have to be a mod level 2. You have to be a mod level 2. So I've apparently got to set some people up as mod level 2s. I wonder, if I set one person as a mod level 2, can the rest of them be mod level 2s as well? Or do I have to do it all? How do I set somebody as a mod level 2? Panel commands, user database. Ooh. Maybe this will work. Edit user. That looks good. Battle tag, stream level, recruit, interesting. Ah, mod level 2, there we go, save. Gav is a mod level 2. Hectic, edit user. Hectic is a mod level 2, save. Anybody else here? I think those are all the mods we have here right now. So there you go, now y'all are mod level 2s. Hectic, I did set you and Gav as mod level 2s. There's the game coming up. I like to think I'm friends with Dawson. As another streamer, he can trust you. Nice. Yeah, Hectic is a moderator. I trust Hectic. I watch his stream. He knows what he's doing, so I appreciate him helping us out because we've got Deepbot installed. We've got the credits going, and I did need some help with that. Hectic, thank you for stopping by the way. Okay, need to be a special mod level. I believe I'm on mod level 1, but I need to be mod level 2. Hectic, you are mod level 2 now. It's a little hard to see. PureFX, gosh, I wasn't checking the chat. I was talking through it, so I did go back. Oh, my bad, though. Gosh. I should have thought of that. I did go back and drag it over so you could see it. Check down. Okay, that wasn't it. Did I miss any other questions? How do I get to where you are? Bebo Josh, what do you mean, how do I get to where you are? You're talking about the mods? The mods? It is, it depends on if you have it in Steam or not. And if you have it in Steam, you need to scroll up a little bit. They put the Steam link in chat. If somebody could toss the Steam link in there again. For Bebo Josh right there. Bebo Josh, get to the Steam link. Let's see here. Copy, because Steam will auto-update and potentially break KSP because of wrong mod version. Oh, that actually makes some sense, JoJo. We're able to do with credits, participate in giveaways. Kerbal Stuff is also a great place for mods. Yeah, crew, I just go to the forum link there and kind of be agnostic as to where it's hosted, because that forum link has all the mods, and then each mod person decides where they want to host it. So depending on the mods you get, you can just go straight there. I need to do that a little bit more. I like Kerbal Stuff. I really do like Kerbal Stuff. I need to give it a little bit more love. You're fairly sick, so I don't plan on going anywhere. I'm checking chat right now and seeing if I've missed anything else. Drita Morgan. Welcome, Drita. I will definitely answer some of those questions about WAD and IJKL. One is for translation, one is for rotation. I use both of them to dock. Quantitas, yes, it's Kerbal Bootcamp Saturday. I started at 2 p.m. I was here at 2 p.m. But we just got the mods installed. Swimming 72, Josh, in this stream, will we learn to dock? Swimming, that's usually not one of the first things we do in boot camp. We just try to get out to the moon. But we will see. If we have time at the end, we'll get it done. I got caught up with chat. Excellent. I got it caught. Doss, I dare you to make the best basement with only 5 pieces, but you can use those pieces as many times as you want. Flevkoto, catch me during a free play or challenge mission, and I will definitely have some challenges like that. Excuse me. Thanks for the link there, crew. I appreciate you. Let's get going. Gosh. Let's get going. We've got the mod install. If you have questions on the mod install, can you please show how to download from that link? Bebo, I won't be able to... Oh, that's actually a really good idea. Top Hat Dragon, that's a really good idea. Link to the community mods page with the mods command. Interesting. That is actually a really good idea. We'll take care of that at some point. Bebo, chat will help you out. Maybe worth having a nice easy way to turn the key display on and off. Das, the vessel and such tabs in the editor are fixed in the latest version of Kerbal Engineer, so it may be worth having an easy way to turn the key display on and off. The vessel and such tabs in the editor are fixed. Maybe I'll figure that out. I don't exactly understand what you're telling me, Cybertech, but maybe I'll figure it out whenever I get into the game and see something. You're talking about my key display, right? My key display. All right. That makes sense. A can use this KSP. Thank you. Let us keep going. I see a lot of really good ideas about making backup copies and that sort of stuff. We're at boot camp. That's a little bit more advanced topic, but you're right. You can copy this stuff out. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it, but you can just make copies. DRM freestyle, right? You can make copies of your Kerbal Space Academy or your Kerbal Space Program folder. Nice. Thank you, Hectic. We are going to have people earning at least 10 points. And right now, we don't have a lot of people who have 10 points right now. So we will get that done in just a little bit. Just a little bit. Let's get going, and let's actually start flying rockets here. What are we up to? 152, not too bad, not too bad. The 152 official viewers, I guess, huh? Alright, 13. Yeah, let's see here. I'm going to go ahead and start a game. I'm going to start a new save here. I'm going to start a new save. That's actually really weird. Start new. There we go. With my flag, except it is going to be KSA Boot Camp. Today is, let's see here, November 8th is today, so it's going to be 2014-11-08, right like that. I'm going to start this in Sandbox, because this is boot camp, right? This is boot camp, and if you want to, start yourself a Sandbox save in boot camp. I'm going to go a little bit slow. Sandbox save in boot camp. Just start yourself a Sandbox save in the game. I'm going to name it KSA Boot Camp. Today's date, and click start. That's going to give me a nice clean world to get to the moon and do boot camp stuff with. So here we are at the Kerbal Space Center. Remember, I'm acting like you're new to the game. I'm acting like you're new to the game. So when you load into the game, you're going to end up here. You see a bunch of different buildings. All the different buildings that you see in the KSE scene right here, the Kerbal Space Center, are different functions. There's lots of different functions, so let's go over them right quick. Out here, of course, you have the launch pad. You can click there to launch rockets. It looks a little bit like this. These are all stock rockets that come with the game. You can go ahead and launch one of them up. If you click on that and you click on this launch button right here, it'll actually put the rocket on the pad for you. If you're just really raring to go and all you want to do, you don't even want to build a rocket, you just want to go fly one, you can totally put that rocket on the pad right there. It's a super heavy lander. Apparently, this is not a rocket that's going to... Thrustaway 801, and you could actually fly this rocket right here from the pad. It should slowly but surely take off. Yes. So you can do that. Whoa. Dorsal side. There we go. Just from the launch pad, you can load up one of the rockets right out of the game, and you can launch it and start to fly it. This is a super heavy lander. It is apparently super heavy and designed to land. I really don't like the fact that the engines are at 45 degree or at angles. That definitely wastes a whole lot of thrust from the engines to have them at angles like that, but it does look cool, so I guess that's what we were going for. If you want, right like that, you can launch a rocket and fly it around. Of course, you know what I'm going to do, just to appreciate the people who are hanging out in the stream and didn't see me launch a rocket for, like, I don't know, ever. I will just go ahead and move this guy over here, like this, and land him on top of this big building. Now, the big building that I'm landing on top of is the vehicle assembly building. The vehicle assembly building. Slow it down now, Daz. So anyways, you can click a rocket on the pad, you can choose one of the stock rockets, you can click launch, you can fly it around just like that. Don't worry about what I just did, I'll be teaching you how to do that. Maybe we'll just leave that guy there, Bill, Bob, and Jeb, sitting on top of the VAB. Again, welcome to Kerbal Boot Camp. We're going to learn to do landings like that. I was just playing around to give y'all something to look at while we were there. I don't think I'm going to leave him there, though. I'm actually just going to send a crane up there and recover the vessel. We'll go over that stuff in detail. That was the launch pad. By clicking on the launch pad, you can launch a rocket, as long as it's already built. Now, say you don't actually have the rocket built yet. You need to actually build a rocket. You want this building, the vehicle assembly building. If you click on the vehicle assembly building, change my OBS scene. Oh! Nice! You're right. What is wrong with that? Wait a second. There we go. No. There we go. Thank you for that. I just did that entire thing. You were still able to see it, but I had the window. I had the wrong scene. I was capturing the desktop instead. Such an idiot. That's why I need to be checking chat. You still saw what I did, right? You're still able to see it. Oh my gosh. Dosh, change your OBS scene. Thank you. Full screen, please. Yes. Say, focus on the game window. Yes. Your overlay is odd. Yes. I totally messed that up. Welcome to Kerbal Space Boot Camp. I have no clue what I'm doing. Thank you for that, by the way. Oh my gosh. All right. So anyways, I clicked on the VAB. I came over here. Dosh, just helping out. I appreciate you, Brimmer. I appreciate you. I clicked on the VAB. I got this rocket. And in the VAB, I can actually edit it. If I don't like those, but instead I'd like to use some delicious, I don't know, these things. We could totally do that. That looks like a serious rocket right there, doesn't it? Oh, if only I could get it to stick. It's apparently going to clip too much. Maybe this would be a better lander. That looks legit, doesn't it? Anyways, you build rockets in the VAB. We're going to be coming back to here. Let's go back out to the scene. Let's look at the other buildings right quick. Again, I'm going over this as if you've never played the game before. We've got a couple other buildings. The space plane hangar. Just like the VAB, but instead you build space planes there. It actually has a different type of symmetry. The thing you build lays over flat, like this. Instead of being up like a rocket, it lays over flat like a plane. You can click on there and go in there. You've got the tracking station. If you've got some flights in progress, you can click on the tracking station. You can go find them. Since this is a brand new save, I don't have any flights in progress. But from right here, you'd have a list of your flights that you could click on and go fly them. You know, control a different craft. Back here again, we've got the research center, right? Research and development. This facility is closed. In Sandbox, you don't actually need it. You already have all the parts. If you're playing a career or a science save, you'll actually have to use the research facility to unlock parts. If you're interested in that, come back for one of my kickstarting a new career saves or one of my farming science saves. When I do KSA streams on kickstarting careers or farming science, I will show you that building in detail. For today, for boot camp, we're not going to be using it. Other buildings, the astronaut complex. If you want to hire people that you are going to blow up or otherwise crash into the ground, you can come to the asteroid complex. Doesn't cost anything. You can just hire as many as you want, just like that. They become your available list. These are the poor fools that you'll be able to put into rockets. So that is the astronaut complex. It'll also tell you how many you've toasted if you click on the lost tab, right? You've also got the administration building in Sandbox. The administration building is going to be completely closed, so you don't do anything there. If you're in a career save, that building is important because it has some completely unbalanced, overpowered strategies that give you tons and tons of science for money, or tons and tons of money for science. Not going to go over that. That is for a career save. If you're interested in that, watch one of my career play missions. Right over here, you've got the mission control. Mission control, you can get some contracts where you can earn some money. Again, that building right there, the little one that I clicked on, not used in Sandbox. So we've gone over all the buildings. We talked about the launch pad, the VAB, the spaceplane hangar, tracking center, research facility, astronaut complex, administration, and mission control. Of those, we're going to be spending most of our time in the VAB today. So let's go ahead and click on the VAB. Crossover. So DOS, for those of us that can't even click on things, how does that work? I hover over things, they light up, and clicking on them does nothing. Crossover, just try to restart your game. I've had that mod before. Unseeing Whale, are you here? Crossover is having the same unclickable problem that he was having before. Airball P, shame, I was hoping to see a Duna mission. Airball, if you come back to my channel anytime that I advertise a Kerbal Space Academy interplanetary transfer, remind me that I said during boot camp that I would go to Duna for you, Airball. Come into my channel when I do that, and I will do a Duna mission for you. We'll take a really cool rocket to Duna. Let's see here. Let me check the chat now that I'm in here and see if I've missed any questions. There's the plugin library. I think Dosh should have a Kerbal draft raffle at a random time. A Kerbal draft raffle. I don't know what that means. There's Cybertech. I remember reading that. You can always rip out. Okay, I saw that one. There's the giveaway thing. Dosh, help me. They're coming. Call my mom. What, Flivko? There's everybody looking at their credits. My overlay was odd. Thank y'all for helping me out. It was just eventually I saw the pop-up down there that said that. Dosh streaming bootcamp. That's correct. You're right. There's a bit of a big RCS tank in this lander. This is one of the stock ones. I have no clue why it's got so much RCS and so little fuel. Don't talk to me. I didn't do that one. I didn't do that one. The KR2L advanced engine lander. Might be able to land on Gilly. Petey, that's hilarious. Dosh, do you typically get into interplanetary missions during bootcamp? Airball P, no, not during bootcamp. But I do streams where I do Kerbal Space Academy interplanetary transfers, or a lot of the times just during other Kerbal Space Academies, we'll do an interplanetary transfer just because. Come back when you see Kerbal Space Academy interplanetary transfers, and you will get that done. Let's see here, Dosh, I'm hitting a KSP crash, and I am far below 4 gigabytes. The log says the error is DBG help. I don't have any mods that add the DLL. I don't know that one, Blipman. I would try a clean install with no mods and see if the game works fine just to rule that out, and then I would add the mods one at a time. I would add the mods in one at a time and see which one makes it crash, Blip. There's that. Okay. Dosh, for those of us that can't even click on things, Crossover, did you restart the game? Try to restart the game and see if you can click on it and see if that works. Dosh, how do I find the file to move the mod file into? Bebo Josh, you need to tell us if you have it on Steam or if you have it not on Steam. So Bebo Josh, I want to help you out, right? I can't spend the entire time just doing that, but I want to help you out. Do you have it on Steam? Answer, yes or no if you have it on Steam. If he says he has it on Steam, somebody give him the Steam link, and you need to go to that link. You're going to have to change the username probably, right? But that's how you get to it. There may be another way, like a find ksp.exe or something like that somebody had mentioned earlier. Right checks, Dosh, why do the three main Kerbals, Jeb, Bill, and Bob, have orange suits on, but EVA the suits are white? It really bugs me. I've never thought of that, right, Chex? That's a good point. They have on orange suits in the pictures, but when they EVA, they go white suits. Special advanced color change technology. When exposed to vacuum or air, their suits turn white, I guess? Like those coffee mugs that change colors whenever they have heat or radiation or something on it? I don't know. Dosh, you didn't fix the no-click bug by clicking on the squad toolbar. Top Hat Dragon, that was a different bug. That was a different no-click bug. That was in the VAB I fixed the no-click bug. There's a different bug outside the scene where you can click on the VAB itself, right, all the buildings, that keeps you from clicking. Dosh, can you make a KSA flag for download? Let's see here. Dosh, can you fix... Didn't you fix... Cybertech, I understand what you're saying now. I've got it. Thank you, Cybertech. Yes, I see the vessel and resources down there now. Okay. So I can turn that on and off. Somebody remember to remind me to turn those things on and off. Okay, thank you, Cybertech. Can I make a flag? We've been working on some flags. I just haven't gotten one that really sells it, right? I just haven't gotten one that I absolutely love yet. So many people have, like, taken a shot at doing a flag, and I just... I'm still shopping for flags. Cybertech, thank you for that one. Hey, Dosh, back from doing some art. You need the email, you forgot it. I don't even think I told you in the first place. Give KerbalSpaceAcademy@gmail.com a try. Emperor777, KerbalSpaceAcademy@gmail.com. Don't post it into chat. Just listen. If you can hear me, it's KerbalSpaceAcademy@gmail.com, but don't put a link to it into chat. I don't know. Restart it, made me able to click on things, but now it crashes if I try and launch from the pad. Crossover, it crashes if you try and launch from the launch pad. Do you have any mods or anything like that? Das, how do I open the Kerbal Engineer? I got it downloaded and stuff. Where's the button? Bebo Josh, press the backspace or press the backslash button. I will help you out with that. Das, you're going to make Nightbot or F5 ampersand? Yes, but not right now. Not right now, but yeah, Blip, man, we do need to do that. Okay. Looks like I got caught up with the chat. It looks like I got caught up with the chat. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to start off with a very basic rocket. We're going to start off with a very basic rocket. I'm not actually going to build it right now. First, we're just going to get a rocket into orbit. I'm not going to build it. That doesn't make any sense. I am just going to... Should I build it? No, we'll go through the details of building it later. Let me do this. Let me come over here so he sticks out a bit more. Oh, thank you. Good idea. Mod F5 bot. There you go. Thank you. Good idea, Hectic. Thank you. All right. So what I wanted to do was come over here. KSP 125. Let me go to saves. Let me go to boot camp. The last boot camp we did. Ships. VAB. KSA Mooner Trainer Mark II. Copy. Let's go back over here to saves. Today's boot camps. Ships. VAB. Didn't I just do paste? Oh, okay. There we go. It's there. Oh, it scrolled over or something. That's weird. Huh. There it is. Mooner Trainer Mark II. Good deal. All right. Now I can come over here and open up the KSA Mooner Trainer Mark II. I've already built this. I am going to go through building this in the stream. But for now, just to get some action going, right? I'm going to go ahead and fly this. And to start off the stream, after it's been going for an hour and a half. To start off our missions here, the first thing I'm going to do is take this rocket out to the moon, land it, and bring it home. Then I am going to come back. I'm going to show you how to build this rocket. I'm going to explain how Kerbal Engineer works. I'm going to show you the launch profile. I'm going to show you how to get it into orbit. I'm going to show you how to get it to the moon. I'm going to show you how to land on the moon. But to start, I'm going to be demonstrating what, if you stick around for the stream, you should be able to do by the end of boot camp. That's how I want to start. I haven't usually done that. But let's just go ahead and launch this Mooner Trainer rocket. And to start off, let's see here. We need to put a Kerbal in there. I need to add crew manifest, I believe. I don't actually know how to do this. Is there a crew manifest? There's crew manifest. Okay, can I do it from the VAB? Let's go ahead and put that down. Crew manifest. Didn't I just click on that? Configure visible buttons. Crew manifest. Why didn't it show up? Why didn't I get crew manifest? Oh, that's not good. Huh. Apparently you can't do anything to crew manifest in here, so I guess what you do is you put a random Kerbal in here. Like Sondred or Berman Kerman, I guess. Like that. You're not very courageous and you're about half stupid. But let's do this. Let's go save. Nope, let's just launch it. Let's take it out of the pad and let's see how we do it. Not using VAB. Thank you. Thank you for that. F5bot does not appear to have mod. You may just have to refresh the stream for that icon to appear. I've got Berman in there, but I don't want it to be Berman. I actually want it to be somebody in the stream right now. Somebody in the stream. So configure visible buttons, crew manifest, close. Crew manifest, vessel empty, command pod. There we go, command pod, crew roster maybe? Yeah, okay, there we go. So here's what I want. I'm going to choose somebody at random to be in this rocket. If you want to be in this rocket, say something in chat right now. Say something in chat right now. I'm going to drink here. I also might get a snack. But if you want to get into the rocket, tell me. And I'm just going to randomly pick somebody. Jikarez, that's right. Uh-oh. You never know. I don't see the mod symbol for DOSBot either. For DOSBot. You won in this rocket. Buckman, something in chat right now. Squirrel, Nutty, Rocket, Bellarock, something, Game Spitter, Finneris, Pullet, guys, so many names that I don't recognize, but thank you. Look at chat blowing up. You want to show me something. Hectic, I was just going to use, I was totally just going to use Winner in Nightbot. Look at all that. Wow, that's nuts. That's nuts. No brains and half stupid. I think I'm pretty much guaranteed to be that Kerbal. Something in chat right now. You have to cancel the flight? Okay, I'll see if I can do that because he's in the flight right now. So what we need to do, I guess, is this. We would edit somebody else and then we'd put him in this rocket, I bet you. Let's see here. DOS space T, fearsome fish. It would be an honor to serve under your command. I want to go something. You only have to say it once. I'm going to go ahead. And do this. I don't want to die, then don't say anything in chat. Let's see here. The winner is... Is it going to work? Is it going to come up? Why is it not going to come up? Isn't that what it is? It's winner. Is Nightbot there? Nightbot. And the winner is... dot, dot, dot. Nightbot's just being real slow right now. Seriously? I didn't see who the winner was. Did anybody else see who the winner was? And the winner is nobody, apparently. Nightbot fail. I never win anything. Nightbot didn't actually work? What? Nightbot is totally trolling. We killed Nightbot. Winner, Das Valdez. That would be hilarious if I won. And I had to put myself in the rocket and I crashed myself into the moon. Is Nightbot just crashed? Oh my gosh. Nightbot has been in the last few days, it's been crashing often. Nightbot failed. Send Nightbot up. Wait, should I try it? Put Nightbot in the rocket? I think that might be what we do. Nightbot is the winner. Send Nightbot and don't return him. Wrecked, not wrecked. Well, that worked. Let me try it one more time. Let me try it one more time. Let's see. And the winner is... There we go! Lignoba! Bam! Lignoba! It came up immediately that time. We murdered Merrick. Dude, Cadet Lignoba, front and center. Get up here. You're going to get in the rocket. You're going to the moon. Lignoba. Oh, my gosh. So I think what we need to do is, like, edit Sondrid. We're going to name this Lignoba. Did I get that right? Lignoba. Kerman. Edit your courage and stupidity. We're going to leave it like it is. What is that? I don't know what that is. Interesting. Does anybody know what that command does? Apply. We've now got Lignoba Kerbin. What I think we need to do is empty vessel. Add a Kerbal. No. Can I not pick? I can't pick. Oh, wait. Over here. Lignoba. Lignoba Kerbin's... Okay, I'm learning this as well. Lignoba Kerbin is in the command mod Mark 1. Lignoba, how'd you like to go to the moon? Let's do this. Ah, Lignoba, excellent. Let me drink. Let me turn off this. I don't need the SSTO and I don't need the landing right now. Let's turn on Engineer. And we are going to go with... That means he doesn't freak out. Oh, I gotcha. I gotcha. That means he doesn't freak out. Cool, cool. Thank you for that. Send an email with some drawings. Thank you, Emperor. I'll have a look at it. Makes you happy in dangerous situations. Nice. That's hilarious. All right. So I think we're good. Isn't dressed all the time. I hear the moon has good snacks. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to talk through this, but I'm not going to stop at any one part. We're going to go to the moon. I will be doing all of this in detail, including how to build this rocket from scratch coming up. But we are going to take Lignoba out to the moon right now. Yes, you put Kerbal Engineer in the game data folder. That is correct, Bebo Josh. I'm trying to help you out. I'm going to throttle up. That's pressing Z. Panel lock. That's clicking up there. SAS engage. That's pressing T. I'm going to say 3, 2, 1. Goodbye, Lignoba. Let's send you to space. And we are going to fly straight up. Going to test something. Yeah, go for it. Hectic, you do what you need to do. If you need some access that you don't have, go for it. You let me know what access you need to do. Craffle raffle. I don't even know what that means. Craffle raffle. I have parachutes, right? Oh no, we've totally forgot it. Are there stages on this recoverable? Yeah. Oh no. Pale Rider, these are not recoverable stages. This is just a sandbox mooner trainer. It's just a sandbox mooner trainer. Keyword raffle. Oh, okay. Huh. Oh, you'll have to add them. Yeah, Cybertech, when I get into it, I'll add those things. Thank you so much for reminding me. Get ready for the flag ceremony. Folks, with Kerbal Space Academy, I like to keep my launch trajectories really simple. I like to keep them really simple. So, the launch trajectory, the launch profile that I'm going to teach you at today's boot camp is not the most efficient trajectory, but it's really easy to remember and it's really easy to execute. You start by going straight up, until you get to 10 kilometers. Right up there, you can see at the top of the screen, I got to 10 kilometers. Then I press the D key. I press the D key. There we go, and lean over. I lean over until I get to a 45 degree angle. Now it says 90 there on the nav ball, right? That's not actually 90. That is actually a 45 degree angle. You see these gradations right here, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. That is 45 degree angle pitch relative to the horizon. This is 0 degrees. This is 90 degrees. That is a 45 degree angle relative to the horizon. With this rocket, what you do is you burn at this 45 degree pitch, this 45 degree angle, not 0, not 90, until these stages run out. Like that. Then you press spacebar to get rid of those stages. You don't need them anymore. And you turn and burn. You click right here so it says orbit. You turn and you burn right like this until your apoapsis is 80. Now you can see up here in Kerbal Engineer, it says that right now my apoapsis is 67. If you've got Kerbal Engineer, you definitely want that up there. I'll go through how to configure that in just a bit. If you don't have Kerbal Engineer, first off, shame on you. Second off, you can press M to go into the map screen, and the map screen will let you look at what your apoapsis is. When your apoapsis gets to 80, I want you to press X and cut the engine. X will cut the engine for you. A lot of people who have watched a lot of space science fiction sort of stuff don't understand what's happening. They continue burning and continue burning and continue burning, and they never actually turn off the rocket, because in so many science fiction movies, the engines, when you're going someplace, you have the engines on, right? That is what you do. It doesn't actually work that way. Right now, we're in what's called a ballistic trajectory. We have kicked ourselves up into this arc. We will get to the top of the arc, which is called the apoapsis. Apoapsis, we call it, really. Apoapsis. And then we will start to go back down. I don't want that to happen, though. I want to stay in orbit, so I'm going to make what's called a maneuver node that will keep me in orbit. And I will be explaining all of this in detail, but right now, I'm just going to make a quick maneuver node. 80 by 82, that's good enough, that will keep me in orbit. After I've made that maneuver node, what do I need to do, right? I need to get up here. And the problem is, I have launched myself up in this big arc. I've come back down. I'm going to be coming back down. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to come back down. I want to stay up here and frolic around. So what I'm going to do is add more velocity, add more energy to my orbit, and make it so that I miss Kerbin. Here's what I mean by that. And again, this is just the first launch. We're going to go over this over and over again. If you have questions, ask them over there. Ask them over there. But look at what's happening. As I burn this rocket, I am flying straight ahead, angled even with the horizon just about. Do you see how I'm just about even with the horizon? What's actually happening right here, look at how the orbit is changing. I am, what I like to say, missing Kerbin more and more. Every bit of energy that I put into flying this rocket along Kerbin like that, horizontal to the surface, is making me miss Kerbin more and more. Look at that. I keep missing it more. I miss it more. I miss it more. Gravity keeps pulling me down, but the more energy I put in, I miss it more and more and more. Look at that. I keep missing it. I keep missing it. At some point, we're going to miss Kerbin by so far that we're actually not going to hit it. Right like that. That's an orbit. That's good enough. What we did just now, we got ourselves up to a specific altitude above Kerbin. It was about 80. When we got up to that altitude, we leaned the rocket flat. Just like that. You see how that rocket is flat to the horizon? The planet is down here. The rocket is like this. And we put a lot of energy into our orbit. When we put that energy into our orbit, it makes us miss Kerbin. What does that mean? Originally, our trajectory had us falling back down to Kerbin in an arc. What other arcs do you see on the screen right now? The nav ball, haha, you're hilarious. The surface of Kerbin is actually an arc because Kerbin is a sphere. So what I want to do is make it so that my orbital arc matches the arc of Kerbin. In fact, Kerbin is curving away from us at the same rate that we are falling towards it. And when Kerbin is curving away from us at the same rate that we're falling towards it, that's an orbit. We are falling towards the planet, but we're missing it. We're going around it so fast that it curves away from us at the same rate that we fall towards it, and that's how an orbit works. I'll go over it again. For now, let's keep going on out to the moon. I'll talk a lot more about those orbits and how you can play with them. But for now, let's keep going to the moon. To get to the moon, I'm going to find the moon. You can actually scroll around. I'm holding down right click, and I'm scrolling around like this so that I can look around the planet. I can zoom in and out by rolling the mouse wheel back and forth, right? That zooms me in and out. What I want to do is look around until I see something that looks like the moon. That over there looks pretty good. In fact, it's labeled moon. Don't call it Mun. Call it Moon. Personal preference. But I've got the moon out there. The simplest way to get to the moon, I'm going to do the simplest way to get to the moon. I'm not even going to get a maneuver node. What I want to do is fly this rocket just like this. I'm in orbit, huh? I'm going to use it. I don't even care. I should have ditched the stage, but we're not going to worry about that right now. I am going to sit right here and look. Do you see how we're flying around Kerbin? We're kind of flying around the planet in this direction. I'm going to look right like this, and I'm going to do what's called time warp. Time warp is a way in the game to accelerate time so that you don't have to sit here. As it turns out, space is big. Flying through space takes a lot of time most of the time. And the game has a feature, a bit of functionality called time warp that allows you to speed up time so that you don't have to sit there for 3 real world years while your craft flies out to Jewel, right? So to do time warp, I'm going to press the period and comma key. Period will actually increase time warp by 1 step. You see it now says time warp 5x. If I press period again, we go up to time warp 10x. I can press comma to reduce the time warp. You can also see in the upper left hand corner of the screen, right up here, do you see this thing that I'm moving up and down? If you go to the upper left hand corner of the screen, you can see that pressing period and comma increase and decrease the time warp. Do you see how that works? The more period we press, the more time warp we get. The more comma we press, the less time warp we get. It'll actually tell you how quickly time is being warped or accelerated right up there. But what I want to do right here is just sit like this, pointing along the planet. I'll explain more. Pointing along the planet and time warp until I see where I want to go. Where are we going? I said we're going to the moon. I am just going to keep time warping around until I see the moon. Let's see here. Come on, moon. You should be here somewhere. We're orbiting the planet right now. We're going around the planet and we're waiting for the moon to rise over the surface right here. Wait for the moon to rise. If your rocket starts to go off like this, don't worry about it. Just untime warp. Repoint your rocket. Excuse me. Repoint your rocket like this, and then time warp again. You won't be able to actually change the orientation of the rocket while you're in time warp. It actually locks down the physics engine and doesn't allow you to control the pitch yaw roll of the rocket while you're in time warp. So, let's see here. We are continuing on. We're waiting for that moon to rise. Let's go a little bit faster. Waiting for the moon to rise. That's the sun rising. I hope the moon is not hidden in the sun there. Waiting for the moon to rise. Why is my rocket turning around? Because the rocket's heading stays constant, even though you're orbiting the planet. You keep pointing. There it was! There is the moon right there. What I need to do now is turn all the way around. I've got the moon rising here, right? It rose a little bit much, but all I want to do to get to the moon is turn around like this, point at the moon. Call me crazy, but point at the moon like this. Whoops, missed it a little bit. Turned a little bit too much. So let's go ahead and correct that. Point that rocket at the moon and light the engine. And I just want you to burn like this. When the stage ends, ditch it and continue burning. Let's go to the map and see what's happening. Remember how I talked about missing Kerbin? I was adding energy into my orbit, and that made me miss the planet. Now I'm adding even more energy into my orbit. I'm going faster and faster and faster around Kerbin, and it is making me miss Kerbin more and more and more. In fact, before I was roughly circular, I was falling at just about the same rate that Kerbin was curving away from me. Now, Kerbin is curving away from me a lot faster than I am orbiting it. So we get this right here. It's called an elliptical orbit. And I am missing Kerbin less and less. Do you see how that happens? Do you see how the more energy I put into this orbit, the more I miss the planet? In fact, I can put so much energy in the orbit, I won't even be orbiting the planet anymore. I will escape the planet and go flying off in the sun or something like that. But we are going to continue putting energy into this orbit just straight like this. I was just pointing at the moon, remember? And continue missing Kerbin and Kerbin more and more until we hit the moon. Now, Das, the moon is over here. You're going this way. You're burning at the moon, but you're not actually going towards the moon. What's the deal? Remember, orbits aren't like you see in science fiction. Orbits are actually curves 99.9999% of the time, probably 100% of the time. And the moon is in an orbit going around the planet like this. We are in an orbit kicking ourselves up, putting more and more energy until we go up like that. And that right there, did I put too much in it? Let's see here. Oh, that's great. Now I can't add it as a target. Come on. Ah, bother. Well, whatever. Let's just keep putting energy into our orbit and see what happens. There we go. That right there was the Mooner Encounter. For some reason, I couldn't set it as a target. But I just kept burning until I got this Mooner Encounter. And watch, because I burned when the moon rose like that, the more I burn, the closer we get to the moon. Let's actually go back to the craft to see what it looks like. So see what we've done. I've created an orbit that has so much energy in it like this. It's going to sling me all the way out here. And I'm going to go way up here to the apoaps. I'm going to start coming back around. But when I start to come around, what's going to be there? The moon is going to be there. The moon's over here right now. We're going to meet it over here. That's because while we're flying along this blue line, the moon's going to be traveling on its own path. And as it travels on its own path, when we get there, it is going to be there as well. We don't burn straight. We don't try to fly straight towards it. We have to take into account the amount of time it takes us to move along that orbit and the amount of time it takes the moon to move along the orbit. A lot of times you'll hear the analogy like shooting a moving baseball with a or hitting a basketball that you've thrown with a baseball that you've thrown. It's like this basketball is arcing through the air and you have to throw a baseball at it arcing through the air, and you have to hit the basketball with the baseball so that you can get this right here. In fun, anything that escapes. Oh, I'm not even. I don't agree with that, because it is still in orbit. After you escape the planet, you'll be in a solar orbit. In fact, if it was an in-body physics thing, you would be in orbit all the time. Even if you have a suborbital trajectory, that's still a type of an orbit. So, anyways, let's just go on out to the moon. I will check chat when I get in orbit around the moon. Let's go all the way out there, though. I've already got the encounter. All I have to do right now. Let's look at this. That Mooner Encounter, let me get out there. That Mooner Encounter is going to take us a day. Where is it at? 3 hours and 8 minutes. A day, 3 hours and 8 minutes. I'm not going to sit here in real time for a day, 3 hours and 8 minutes. What I actually want to do is time warp. And I'm just pressing period to increase the time warp. Look in the upper left. You see the time warp, right? And see us move along this orbit. We are going up this orbit, and we are going to meet the moon. And look at the moon. You see the moon coming around? Let me time warp a little bit more. The moon is coming around. It looks like we're going to beat it, right? But remember, when we get up here, we're slowing down. Do you see our velocity slowing down? And we're actually going to loiter up here at the apoaps while that moon comes around. So see, we're slowing down, slowing down, slowing down, because we're getting up to the top of that orbit so far away from the planet. At some point, we're going to actually not come to a stop, but we're going to start falling back towards the planet. And we are loitering right now. Look at that moon catching up to us. We're just waiting for the moon to get here. Drink. Thank you, Bilal. Now we're in the moon's sphere of influence. The moon is right there. What I want to do is go ahead and land on the moon. And so I am going to do another maneuver node right here. I'm just going to put a maneuver node. I can't put nodes down. That's annoying. Anyways, I need to do this right quick to fix it. There we go. All right. Now it should be fixed. It is fixed. If you ever run into that bug where you can't put a node on your trajectory, you can just go ahead and EVA a Kerbal, put him right back into the pod, and that usually fixes it. So I'm going to put another node there that's going to put me in a rough orbit around the moon. So this is coming up. Let's talk a little bit about the node. This is coming up in 1 hour, 14 minutes, 25 seconds. You can see it right there. And I am going to need to do that burn. In order to do the burn, I want to split my burn time in half. Do you see where it says estimated burn right there? The node is coming up in 1 hour, 14 minutes, 13 seconds. And it tells me, hey, DOS, it's going to take you, using this engine, about 28 seconds to do the burn. So in order to do that burn, I'm going to split that in half. And I'll explain in detail why we do that later. But I'm going to split the burn time in half. I'll show you some cooler ways to split it in half, because engineer can help you out here. But I'm going to split it in half down to 14 seconds. That means that when this says node in T-minus 14 seconds, I'm going to light the engine and put this much energy into the orbit. I'm going to explain all these things in detail later in boot camp. So let's go ahead and time warp. All the way down. 4, 3, 2, 1. There's 15, 14. If you time warp too fast, it's very easy to miss your checkpoints. To fly right past, to time warp right past something you need to be doing. Anyways, surprise, there's the moon. There we go. 2 minutes, 1 minute. I said 14 seconds, right? So here we are, Lignoba. Cadet Lignoba, it's time for you to begin your Mooner Circularization Burn, or whatever you want to call it. And you are going to start your burn at T-minus 14 seconds. So that's 22 seconds, 20 seconds, 19, 18, 17, 16. I know I already love a Cybertech. 15, 14, light your engines. I press Z to do that. And I am going to do this burn to put myself in this Mooner orbit. Right like this. Now I'm doing some other things. I'm pointing at this blue cross. Some of you may have seen the blue cross. The blue cross is your node heading indicator. When you put a node on there and you want to execute a maneuver a certain way, the blue cross tells you which way you should be pointing. So I am pointing at the blue cross to actually execute that maneuver. When it gets down to zero, basically on the burn right there, you press X to kill the engines. That is going to put us in a circular orbit around the moon. Roughly circular. 22 by 29. Close enough for this. What I want to do now, when I'm landing on the moon. Dude, the man of horror, thank you for the follow. I appreciate you. Welcome to Kerbal Bootcamp. I'm Dos Valdez. What I want you to do now, I will get to that. Somebody probably posed the question. When I get into orbit around the moon, I said I would check chat. So now that we're in orbit, let's get old Lignoba here. Let's give him a good shot of the moon. Right like that. Let's go IVA mode so he can see the moon. Lignoba, you should be preparing for landing. While you're preparing for your landing, I'm going to check the chat. Let's do this. Let's go screensaver mode, and I am going to check chat and drink and that sort of stuff. Press Z. I repeat, press Z said no NASA guy ever. Good thing we're in Kerbal Space Academy. We're not in NASA. All right. I'm going to scroll up. I'm checking chat and drinking. See if I missed any questions. You guys are ridiculous. Honestly. There's a help doc. I'm a machine. Cheeseburger. Welcome back to the stream. SNTXZ. Thanks for enrolling in Kerbal Space Academy. You're watching Kerbal Boot Camp right now. Act like you've never played the game. I'm going to get you to the moon. I'm going to explain everything in detail. Right now, we're already at the moon. I know we're already at the moon. But I am going to go back to the VAB. I'm going to walk you through every single concept you need to know in detail to do this. I wanted to start off to show you what you'll be able to accomplish by the end of the stream if you hang out in boot camp. But we're about to do this Mooner landing. I'm checking my chat right now. I appreciate you. When is your next boot camp? Bebo, I do it every other weekend. Keymap. I got it. Lignoba is scared, apparently. Ah, the keyword raffle works. Nice. The glitch I was getting was environmental visual enhancements. Remove that and it lets you at least sit on the launch pad. Were you able to launch? That would be cool. Do a barrel roll. Cow Advanced Warfare, I know it took a while, but this isn't really a barrel roll. It is an SAS roll. But here, let's give old Lignoba something to worry about. I'll just leave the craft like that. Lignoba, hang on to your shorts, man. Get ready for the flag ceremony. We're actually going to do a giveaway when we land this craft on the moon. We're going to give away a copy of Kerbal Space Program. Dos, remember the new node readouts? Yep, got that one. Did I miss anything else? Test something. Okay, I remember seeing that. So let's scroll down. Scroll down. Crossover, let me know. Let me know if you got that fixed. How Advanced Warfare, following the stream since yesterday. That's awesome. Lignoba, you getting tired yet? Just because I'll add 5 points to Cow. Nice, Hectic. That's cool. Thank you for testing that, by the way. Next boot camp, not next weekend, but the weekend after. We do boot camps every other weekend. That kind of stuff, but something now is stopping you. Angry Beaver, welcome to Kerbal Boot Camp. And Tars. Did I miss somebody? Caretaker 38, Captain Rex 704, Tars 21, Angry Beaver. Wow, my follows got messed up for a second. The Man of Horror, Dynamic Aura, Pool Fan, Anispear, JTN. I'm just making sure I got caught up with everybody. Some of those were from a while ago, but apparently I just got a ton of follows at once, and it looks like it was the bot getting caught up. Let's see here. You don't like Engineer MechJeb Master Race. Don't even get me started. Infun. It looks like Infun. Infun, dude, welcome to the Academy. And it looks like you've got a lot of actual rocket science knowledge. And you are absolutely right. Real rockets don't often reignite their engines. It's not good for them. It's also difficult to deal with the fuel, right? The fuel sloshing around. A lot of times, one of the fueling methods is actually using the acceleration of the rocket to create artificial gravity, pushing the fuel to the rear of the tank so that they can use it. Often, they don't redo the rock or reignite the rockets. You're exactly right. There's actually a mod that can simulate not reigniting your rockets. There's a mod that can simulate that, which is kind of cool. But Infun, welcome to the channel, and thanks for adding to it by putting all of that additional rocket knowledge in there. I really do appreciate people that just get excited about it, right? I really do appreciate you, Infun, so thank you. Getting to orbit. I love it. Buckman's getting to orbit. Throwing yourself at the ground and missing. Folks, if there's something that you want me to actually pay attention to, remember to use the word DOS. Say DOS. Getting to orbit is like throwing yourself at the ground and missing. Buckmints, I absolutely love that saying. Analogy, I guess? Kind of. Yeah, it's kind of an analogy. I'm already missing Kerbin. I miss Kerbin so much. Basically, LADV, basically orbiting is falling towards an object, but keep missing it. That's exactly right. That's exactly right. Thanks, DOS. That was one of the few times I was wrong. That's why I called it out. Just kidding. You were wrong about not reigniting the rockets. There are some engines that are designed to reignite, and there are some engines that are not designed to reignite, so I'm not going to say you're wrong. Mayonnaise, not a rocket fuel. Not a rocket fuel. Hectic. Don't make me demod you. This is just a Mooner mission. This is an awesome Mooner mission. It's not just a Mooner mission. Jeez, seriously, dude? Rutnut is taking 6 years to get to go to... Guys. Even at boot camp, another thing that I love to see in my channel is people who come in and post screenshots of their own Kerbal Space Program mission reports. So if you have a mission, if you're following along with this, or you have another mission that you've been working on, and you've got something totally awesome, feel free to upload screenshots and put them up on Imgur or something like that and put a link in my channel. Don't abuse it. Keep them KSP related or keep them space related, but right now you don't actually have to get permission to post links because this is such an awesome community. So if you've got a mission report, such as Rutnut, who's taken 6 years to get to Duel, Rutnut, if you have some screenshots up on Imgur or something like that, feel free to post a link to the screenshot album or something like that in the channel. I love to see it, because I love to see people play KSP. Absolutely. Let's see here. DOS is not noticing your clever jokes. Time warping is becoming a Time Lord. That's because you didn't say DOS in them, LADV, and I didn't really see them if they're not highlighted in red. Mayonnaise is not a rocket fuel. I got that one already. Did someone move the moon? Flying to the moon like in the old days when there was no map viewer and maneuver nodes. You're exactly right, Black Templar. I want to show how easy it was. DOS, are we going to make a moon impactor, says Blipman. No, not going to do that. Need a mod that puts all these celestial bodies in polar orbits on April Fool's. ShadowFan216, hey DOS, sorry I'm late for boot camp. What did I miss? We installed mods and we launched this rocket. We basically installed mods, did a tour of the KSC, and we launched our first rocket on this Mooner mission. Dan for Rescue, welcome back, Dan. Haven't seen you in a while. Welcome, welcome, welcome. That's not better atmospheres. You're right, it's Astronomer's Pack or something. Oh, I need to update it. I think that's what you're saying. DOS. Ellipse is the word you were after, says Cybertech, the maker of Kerbal Engineer. Cybertech. Remember, one of the things that I try to do is keep the terminology simple, right? I don't want to sit here and be like, oh, you need to calculate your orbital rest trajectory, da 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 da. I don't want to do that. I want to help new players or people who are maybe not even played the game yet, help them understand that we don't have to use all these technical terms. That's why I say angry triangle, right? We don't have to use the technical terms. We can learn those later. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to play this game. You can do a lot of stuff in the game without knowing all of those technical terms. So I do sometimes use common, colloquial language whenever I describe what's going on, such as burn, pink, angry triangle. I definitely do that. Let's see here. Next lesson, how to slingshot around the sun, go back in time, and rescue a whale. Mr. Junks. Can you explain? Oh, Jay McNarley. DOS, can you explain what each color line represents? Jay McNarley, next time I go to the moon, I will try to remember to explain why I get different color lines. That was a great question, Jay McNarley. Thank you. Drink. I know I need a drink. Rutnut, DOS, the worst mistake going to the moon is running out of fuel. Crashing when landing is the one that makes you rage. You're not even kidding. The in-body. Oh, the in-body mod. Oh my gosh, let's not even get going there. In-fun. Posted a link to YouTube. What was this? In-body simulation. I think it's because, doesn't it show that they're going to, like, rip out of orbit or something? Eventually, don't they rip out of orbit? Val gets ejected. Lathe keeps giving, like, gravity assists to Val. And eventually, Val gets ejected. That's actually really cool, dude. In fun. That's a really awesome video. Thank you for that. Why are some questions red? Captain Rex, why are some questions red? If you say the word DOS or you say the word question, it'll actually highlight it in red, and I make sure that I answer those questions whenever I check up my chat like I'm doing right now. We'll be using the new Kerr suicide burn figures. We can do that later on this stream. I'll prepare for landing as soon as I finish snacks, DOS. Like Nova. Hey, DOS, what did I miss? Snuggly Squid, you didn't miss much. DOS, I have a question. When re-entering Earth or Kerbin's atmosphere, what causes the planes to appear? Shadowfan 216, here's what I want you to do. Shadowfan and anybody else who wants a real-world simulation of why you get these re-entry effects, why things set on fire when they come back in the atmosphere, I want you to get your hands like this. I want you to put them together. I want you to press them together, and I want you to rub them really hard. You probably hear me rubbing my hands together. Rub your hands together really hard. And notice what happens. I have my kids do this, right? It's science class. Rub your hands together and notice what happens. Your hands get hot. Why do things light on fire when they come back into the atmosphere? Because the air is moving over them. It's causing friction on the craft so freaking fast that it gets hot. It gets so hot that it ignites. It gets on fire. It heats up because of the friction between the air and the craft. That's why you get those flames happening. The exact same concept as rubbing your hands together. However, one hand would be air, and the other hand would be craft. And you could actually try to make your hand hot just by rubbing it against air. It's not going to work. Imagine how fast you have to be going to make an object hot by rubbing air against it. You got to be going pretty darn quick. So that's why that happens. Thanks. That's a good question. I haven't actually answered that one on stream before. But thank you for asking, Shadowfan. I appreciate you. Dos Valdez does not condone drinking while driving spacecraft. Obi-Wan, Kerbal, Nobi, Padawan here. Miklo, welcome to Kerbal Boot Camp. Good to have you here. I guess stupidity has to do with science, but what does Kerbal do? Panther Rush, in the stock game, stupidity and Kerbage are just for fun. They don't actually mean anything. They're just two randomly generated things that are you can make jokes about, right? They don't actually mean anything. Yeah, I should be okay. There we go. They don't actually mean anything. It's just something to be funny about. It's just like a role-playing funny sort of thing. Thanks for joining, though, Panther Rush. Yeah, DOS, I managed to launch and that kind of stuff, but something is now stopping me from using the flight viewer. The flight viewer. Crossover, what do you mean, the flight viewer? The flight viewer. I don't get that. You what, mate? DOS Valdez. What's up, Man of Horror? Welcome back. Why are some questions red? Captain, sorry it took me a minute to explain that one, but it's so that I can get them done. It's so that I can review my chat and make sure I answer everything. Is it a space plane? Is it a rocket? No, it's a Beyblade. Well done, DOS. All right, DOS, I have a question. Okay, I got you there, Shadowfan. Did you do the thing? Guys, you don't have to ask the questions twice. They do get highlighted in red. I scroll back through my chat, and I do answer the questions. That is what I do. I'm DOS Valdez. I answer questions. I want people to understand how the game works. How much do you want a ticket to cost, and how many do you want to limit per user? Hectic. Tickets are going to cost 10, I believe. Hectic. Paging Hectic, I believe tickets are going to cost 10. For the first raffle, tickets will cost 10. That'll get a lot of people in there. Lignoba, friction of the atmosphere. Maybe we can use Lignoba to demonstrate friction of the atmosphere when we re-entered. Jackson, you can actually get the HUD info in Kerbal Engineer as well. So I'd rather just have one mod as opposed to two. Infan, thanks, DOS. Rocket Fuel, no, say DOS. Is DOS Boot any good? Kind of. I had Orbital Mechanics and Physics, and I was the best in class just because of KSP. Somebody link that XKCD comic. DOS, I have problems to dock. Quick ticks. Nasia, at the end of the stream, if we have time, I'll walk you through a dock. I usually don't do docking, I think, as part of Kerbal's boot camp, but if you're around at the end of the stream and we have time, I'll get through a dock for you. Also, you can go to my YouTube. You can go to my YouTube, and I've got docking videos where I just go through docking drills for 2 hours. That is on YouTube. Top Hat Dragon, want to see my Vorner Von Braun style mission? Top Hat Dragon. Time out. Top Hat Dragon, wait. If you're telling me that you have a Werner Von Braun mission going out to Duna, and if you show me a screenshot that looks like something like this right here, where is it at? I gotta scroll up some. This Wernher von Braun STS, his original 1969 STS design using interplanetary kicker stages. You are awesome. Absolutely awesome, Top Hat Dragon. Because this screenshot that I have right here, this is Drill 7, by the way. You can find him on DeviantArt. This is an artist rendition of Wernher von Braun's original STS program. It eventually is what morphed into the space shuttle, right? But this is how Wernher von Braun said that we were going to get to Mars. And I've actually designed two days ago, I designed on the stream those parts right there using Wernher von Braun's designs to get to an interplanetary destination. Top Hat Dragon, I would love to see those screenshots. I would absolutely love to see those screenshots. Let's see here. Thank you. Chat Beacon. Not even yet, yeah. I got 6 satellites in geo orbit for a comm satellite. Oh, I do need to do a chat beacon. How do you use that rocket to slow down with that rocket? Wait. How do you use that rocket to slow down with that rocket? Thundersleet, or Thrustleet, actually. I didn't quite understand that question. Why haven't I landed? Because I'm checking up with chat. It's taking forever. This is what I do, Manafort. I answer questions in my chat. We will get landed on the moon, but I do answer questions. Air's getting hot due to compression, not friction. All right, that's okay. Isn't actually the compression. I don't know. It's part of the friction. Serving Europe is broken. Did you check out the Space Shuttle Mission 2007? I haven't seen that one yet. Credits. Into the stream around what time? A while. Das, you can use K to get HUD info, but I much prefer Void. I don't know. I like Kerbal Engineer. I'm going to go with you, Kerbal Engineer. Stream is up again. All right. Experimental Launchpad, level of stupidity effects. All right. I've won. Let's see here. I've got, what is this? Me, chat, beacon. It's time for me to land this craft. Let's see what we've got. Let's go ahead and stop it from spinning. I'm in the lunar orbit. I don't want to land on the dark side of the planet. I want to land on the light side of the planet. So what I'm going to do... Oh, that looks like a great place to land right there. What I'm going to do is go ahead and point retrograde like this. Retrograde means pointing backwards. I'm going to take energy out of the orbit. Remember what I was talking about orbiting, right? And it's falling and missing the planet. I want to stop missing the planet. I would like to actually hit the planet. In order to do that, I need to take energy out of my orbit so that I stop missing the planet and I actually fall towards the planet faster than it curves away from me. That's going to make me impact it. Let's see what we've got. I'm going to time warp around. I'm just going to go for a random landing site. A totally random landing site. I am just going to... That's not a bad orbit. Come on around this way. And when I get right, I guess, right here, I'm going to start burning retrograde. I'm going to remove energy out of my orbit and watch what happens. GameSprider, I can answer that one right quick. I just pressed T to turn on SAS. SAS is Stability Augmentation System that keeps your rocket from spinning or changing its pitch yaw roll. It changes it from pitch yaw roll. When you turn it on. So that's just a game feature. You press T. As long as you've got the control authority to do it on the rocket, I'll talk about that. That is how I stop that spinning. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to take some energy out of my orbit and watch what happens. Let me see if I can get a good angle here. When I take energy out of my orbit, by pointing my rocket backwards, do you see how we're going along the moon in that direction right there? And I have my engine pointed in that direction, so that's actually going to slow me down. I'm going to take energy out of my orbit. And when I do that, any amount, Hectic, any amount, thank you. 10 each and any amount. 10 each and any amount, because the most anybody has right now is like 20. So 10 per ticket, any amount, Hectic. Thank you, by the way. Thank you so much. So let's take some energy out of this orbit, and y'all watch what happens. I'm actually going to go like that, take energy out of my orbit. You see how I get worse and worse at missing the planet, the moon? In fact, I'm going to get so bad at it that I'm going to miss it that much. That looks good. That actually looks pretty good. Ionic Wake, I will open those links, but I can't check them on stream, especially if they're not just like a quick screenshot or something. Biography.com kerbal.com/people/Werner von Braun. Jeez, I don't think I'm going to be able to get that one read in the stream right now. But thank you for those links. I appreciate you, Iconic. So now I've got my trajectory looking a little bit like that. I'm just going down to the moon. And remember, this is just a demonstration mission. We're going to go back and we're going to go over in excruciating detail every single